Hey guys, it's Mark Oakley here with another episode of From the Drawing Board, and today I'm shooting on a very old camera. It's been sitting next to my drafting board for like, several years, I would say. And I wonder what this thing's like for shooting video. I wonder if it says in the bottom when it was made. It came from Japan. That's a good thing. Japan's a good place for cameras. I hear they make good cameras. I wonder if they have a... I'd like to know when this thing was made. It's like really old. Look at that. 8 megapixels. 8 megapixels at the time. That was nothing to sneeze at, you know? Some people with their 6 megapixels, they go, ooh, you got 8 megapixels on that? Got yourself a good camera there, Joe. So, and you can see like, okay, you know it's an old camera. I don't know if you can see that, but I'm going to hold this... Okay, this thing that I'm holding on, that I'm shooting on right now is my little Sony HDR, too many numbers. It's a little teeny action cam that's pretty cool. I've done like the last bunch of little videos on it. I took this with me to Toronto and it served pretty well. It has a good mic on the thing, which is surprising for an action cam. But anyway, thing is, you know, both my hands are full. So I'm going to put this in my mouth. Yeah, and that way I get both hands to manipulate the Canon PowerShot SX100 IS from before, from the past. Okay, we're gonna blast through the past, but I'm gonna take you around here. I won't be able to talk because this will be in my mouth. I'll mime. Okay, here we go. You know, I thought maybe I'll pull that old hunk of plastic out of out of the dust pile that had lain in since, oh god, how long ago was it? I can't even remember when I bought this thing, but it was several years back. And I remember it was like, I looked really, really hard around because I wanted to find something where I could control the white balance, not have an auto change. Because I was going to do like drawing videos, and I wanted to show my drafting board, my digital drafting board. And what I found with my previous... my previous camera was very old, very low res. I think this thing's shooting on 640 by 480, so this is like just a teeny tiny postage stamp of a video. It's like playing Doom from the 90s, you know, very low res. Am I all chunky right now? Am I chunky? Let's see. Is that chunky? It's chunky here. Okay. We can live with a little bit of chunky. Anyway, I wanted to try it out and see what it looked like. And anyway, the thing is with, you know, previous cameras, it was auto white balance. So I put my hand in front of the, you know, the big bright white canvas and it would lower the brightness. The camera's like, whoa, brightness is lower, auto adjust, and then everything would turn dark. And then I pull my hand away, you know, to talk to the camera or talk to the audience or whoever. I live a lonely life. There was no one in my studio. Oh. But, you know, then the camera's like, oh man, the canvas is back. You know, crank up the ISO. You crank up the white balance. I really need to learn my camera terms. There's a lot of science involved here that I'm not appraised of. I took a camera course way back in like grade 10. So I was skinnier and smaller and ganglier and taking a camera class. But I didn't learn very much because... It was first thing in the morning, first class, and I, you know, when you're a teenager, I think it was particularly bad with me. I noticed there were a lot of kids who were able to do things like, yeah, we're going to join the cross-country ski team. We're going to, you know, join the school newspaper. We're going to do all these after-school extracurricular activities. They look like a lot of fun, you know. They were just bright, happy kids doing cool things. It was like one of those high school musicals. It was great. But then the rest of us, the ones who were sort of biologically requiring a little bit more sleep, you know, because we're busy growing, I think turning, you know, from a 5-foot person to a nearly 6-foot person, I think I'm over 6 feet. I haven't measured recently. But anyways, that just takes a lot of energy, you know, and so you're sleeping all the time. So I'd roll out of bed and barely be functional. My alarm would definitely wake me up. And I get into class, and the first hour was just a write-off. And so in the photography class, I'm like, yeah, you know, in your mind, you want it to be perfect. You want to be all, you know, clean washed with your little pencil all sharpened, ready to go, and take some cool pictures and become an artist and learn about film developing and use the darkroom. We had darkrooms back then. Really, really cool. But all I could do was, you know, I'd sit in my chair and just sort of like try and keep my eyes open. I learned nothing, you know, except the cameras were complicated because, you know, like you've got your f-stop and you've got your ISO, and you have your focal length, and all three are like this morphing equation, and if you try and get one thing just right, the other two have to change. But wait, I wanted this thing over here, and now it affects, you know. I found it very complicated. And so digital cameras apparently haven't solved that, except this particular one that I'm shooting on, this old Canon. It's an SX, to turn my head sideways to read it, an SX PowerShot 100 IS. It was the cool, it was the shit at the time, you know. And I think it was about $300. Now, you can't give these things away. You look on eBay, they're like, you know, I'll sell you this camera bag. Oh, there's a camera in the bottom if you want it. You know, it's like seriously, they're like $20 if you're looking for one of these things. I don't know what you'd use it for because video is all 1080p now. Everything's widescreen and camera technology has gotten so much better, you know, so these things are kind of silly, but I wanted to try it out, you know, and so that's what this is all about. Okay, so let's close that up again. We don't need that on. How do you turn it off? It's a little button here. There you go. It has this cool little, you know, a fixed lens, so it's not like one of those really high-end cameras. I kind of like fixed lenses. It takes a whole decision tree and cuts it down. It gives you a stump, but the stump's pretty good. You can sit on it and be restful, and you know where you are. You don't have to like go climbing up into the branches of decision making and figure out which lens is going to be the right one for the you know, the situation you're in, your shooting environment. You get one lens and you're happy, and if you're not happy, well, no one cares, right? So you make do. And when you stop thinking, anyway, we're not going to get into the philosophy of stumps and decision trees. But anyway, this thing is, I don't know, man. I didn't get a whole lot of use out of it when I had it. I shot a couple videos on it and they looked terrible because I just couldn't make my videos look all clean and sharp like all the other fancy YouTubers. I'm not even sure if YouTube was, oh no, it was. YouTube was definitely around, but it wasn't quite as populated as it is today. But anyway, check this out. I'm going to put this on the ground here. Let's see. So you can sort of see in these edges, there's that dust buildup. And, you know, the kind of dust where you know it's been sitting forgotten and unloved on a shelf for many, many years, as this has been. I was surprised that it even turned on. I mean, you know, the batteries were still good. And, oh, wow, and check it out. This is cool. You know you're in the past when the batteries look like this. I did actually change them. These are some inner loop batteries. They're apparently really, really good. Sure cost enough. But double A's, man. Double A batteries are the best because I don't know why everyone's so excited about these cameras you gotta plug in to charge and these little weird square proprietary batteries you gotta plug into a special charger. And, you know, if you're out in, you know, South America and you're exploring the jungles, you're in Venezuela and you're looking to get some amazing video footage,
and your batteries run out and there's nowhere to plug them in. But if you go back into town, doesn't really matter where you're in the world, you're going to be able to find a couple of AA batteries. They're a universal energy source. And so a little camera like this, it's made for exploring, not like these homegrown, what are they, lithium ion things. You're just tied to civilization. Why would you want that? That's not freedom. That's not love, So we need more cameras that run on double A's. Actually, I check this out over here. I'm gonna sidestep on this video. So these right here, I don't think these are even legal. I found them on eBay and they were very, very hard to come by, and you can't get them anymore. But the thing that's special about these, it's a double A format. Look at that, 3,000 milliwatt hours. I think if you're getting batteries from China, they can print whatever they want on them, and what are you gonna do? They're in China, Like, you get them, this isn't a real 3,000 milliwatt battery. I want my money back, and but that's half the other side of the world. They're like, eh, we're in China. What are you gonna do? Thing is, I think these actually are. This was made by a very enterprising company called Etinesan, and the idea was that this is a lithium ion double A format. And I think there must be some kind of patent agreements or manufacturing standards where nobody makes lithium ion double A's, because it has all the charge characteristics. It holds a much deeper charge. It's very powerful. It gives you a full 1.5 versus the, I think these are like, I think you get like 1.3 volts out of this lithium ion or nickel metal hydride. This is the old chemistry. They're just not as good. And the other thing about these is, like, the power doesn't sort of slowly sap down. You get a solid 1.5 volts until the end, and then it just stops, right? Anyways, like, why not, put this in a double A format? It just seems really sensible. No one does. I'm not really sure what the reason is for that. I have my suspicions. But anyway, some company, I guess, ducked the law. The mafia didn't shut them down in time, and they got a few of these out, squeezed them out. And so I have these really cool lithium ion batteries, and they're pretty cool. I think, you can't put as much chemical in them because the top, I saw a guy on YouTube, he'd taken some apart to show how they worked. The top fifth of this battery is electronics, because, lithium ion has a completely different chemistry, and it puts out either's more volts per battery than you should have, and so it has to limit it, and it has to do some clever things so it doesn't blow your camera up. But this has that, that technology packed in there. Anyway, I got these, and I never use them, because there's something nice, like all your old electronics, they're designed to understand that power dies slowly and has that little battery meter, so you can say, oh, I've got 2 bars left. I can shoot for another 20 minutes, or I can finish my phone call. Here, it lies. It just says, yeah, you're full battery, oh, we're dead. And I found that stressful. So I don't know, it was an interesting experiment, and I don't want to become dependent on them, because you can't get new ones. They're out. They're anyway, that's a funny little I tried it. I learned something, and now they will collect dust, much like my old PowerShot SX100 IS. I don't know what the IS stands for. Is shootable? Is maybe it's just an existential thing. It is. This camera is. Well, that was an interesting experience. I just looked at the footage that came off that thing, and it looks all old-timey. It might even be a neat camera to have if you want to, make it look like you're shooting something in the 70s. It kind of had that sort of low grade, 8 millimeter film camera look. So I don't know, maybe it could add some artificial sketchiness to it. All it kind of seemed to have that. I'll find like an old bicycle from the 70s with a banana seat and ride around and pretend like I'm 12. And this is me when I was a little boy. Ignore the fact that I have a full beard and I'm bent over with age. Just, I'll have to hire someone to play me. And I can shoot it on this thing. I can make like a little retrospective of the life and times of Mark Oakley. Anyway, I thought that would be fun. I hope you enjoyed that. I'll catch you again in another video. Peace out. That's what they used to say in the 70s. Peace out, man. Or maybe that was the 60s. I don't know. I'm a man of my times. It's the year 2019, and it's going to be 2020 soon. Yeah, moving into the future. All right, take care, guys. Like and subscribe if you like this stupid content. And hope you have a wonderful day. Cheers. Catch you in another video. Bye.